40% of Canadian infrastructure have passed their service lives, and we have an infrastructure deficit of $141 billion, especially infrastructure. If we look into bridge infrastructure, if there's an earthquake, many of our bridges, they were built before 1970s. And during that time, we didn't have any strict provisions in the seismic design regulations. The seismologists have predicted a 9-magnitude earthquake may hit the West Coast. If those bridges are hit by an earthquake of this large magnitude, you will see what we can see here, that this kind of damages will take place, where the concrete, the rebar inside will be yielding, the concrete outside will be spalling, and as the concrete loses, then the load carrying capacity will be significantly affected. Eventually the rebar will be rupturing and buckling, and then there's a potential collapse of the bridge pier. In this particular project, what we are trying to achieve, we want to understand how those deficient bridge piers are going to perform during earthquakes. We have two things that we are going to do. One is whether there is a potential repairing technique that we can apply. And once we repair it, then we again apply earthquake load and see whether we can significantly improve its capacity in terms of taking large amount of drift as well as base shear capacity. Another thing we are doing also, like how about rehabilitation or retrofitting of the existing bridge pier before the earthquake comes and hits. We will be using different types of techniques, confinement and energy dissipation elements. Both techniques will be applied to the bridge piers, and then we will see how much it can reduce the damages as well as improve its performance.